Hello everyone, my name is John Odom and I am a drum set and percussion teacher here in East Orlando. Currently I'm teaching at Orlando Fine Arts Academy, which is in Lake Nona. We are a full music and art school, and we offer music lessons for most instruments and voice lessons. We also offer dance and art lessons. Also as a drum teacher, I also travel to students' homes and I can offer both private lessons and also online lessons. And I've got a few beginner students that I'm working with, and it's always good to, you know, have a song or the first song that a beginner student can work on. It needs to be something that's not real difficult to play. So a song that I've chosen for my beginner students, and this is a great song for a student, especially someone who's never played the drums before. This is a song that I recommend they start with. Now, I am only using this music strictly for instructional purposes. I don't claim the rights to the music or anything like that. But the song that I'm referring to is Bruno Mars, okay? And it's his song, Talking to the Moon, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and start kind of explaining it and just go through a description of each part of the song. And so that way, anyone who watches this video, my hope for you is that it'll be beneficial and will help you to understand how to play this song, okay? So this song starts off, Talking to the Moon starts off with just a very soft piano part. There's no drums in the beginning of the song. It's a very quiet intro, okay? And the tempo for this song is actually pretty slow. I believe it's around 73 beats per minute, okay? And so it's not a fast tempo at all. That's another reason why this is a good first song for drum students to learn. Okay, so let me go ahead and start letting you listen to it. And we'll start talking about the different parts of the song and how it's set up. So this is the intro with the piano. Now, as a musician, okay, as a drummer, you should already be keeping track of the tempo, feeling the tempo, even though you're not playing here. Okay, your tempo here, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. You can do a little bit of cymbals here on this part. I like count 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. You're going to do a swell here. Alright, what is a cymbal swell? Well, a cymbal swell is where you actually get the sound of the cymbal, okay, to actually swell up or to get louder, okay? Now, the best way to play a cymbal swell, you're actually going to play this with the shoulder of your drumstick, not the tip on the bow of the cymbal, but it's actually going to be on the edge. And that's how you get that swell. Okay? Now, it's important that you let the sticks move. So how do we get to where we can do this? Well, my recommendation, I always tell my students, practice on your practice pad. Okay, single strokes, single stroke roll on the practice pad. You know, you getting used to allowing the sticks to move freely in your hands, okay? Very important. So the cymbal swell. Talking to the moon. It's a real quick swell. You're not holding it out for a long time. It's not like a rock song. It's a trash can ending and you're doing a loud cymbal swell. It's not like that. It's real quick. It's just kind of a quick burst. Right there, okay? All right, let's keep going. I'll back it up just a little bit to lead into that. Okay. Do another swell here. So right here, all I'm doing, 5 soft hits, 5 quiet hits. Tip on top, tip of the stick on top right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Volume comes down. Here's where you come into the groove. Now, This is actually an eighth note groove, which is going to be 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay? But total beginners, that might be difficult to do. So I'm going to actually play this with a quarter note groove. Quarter notes are going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's your first basic drum groove. You're going to play the bass drum with your foot on count 1, snare drum right here on 2, bass drum on 3, snare on 4, and match that up with your hi-hat. Hi-hat's going to play all 4 quarter notes, okay? So that's why I'm going to play this right now, is with the quarter notes on the hi-hat. I'll demonstrate that now with an eighth note groove. Try the eighth note groove first. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And if you're not able to get those eighth notes in, then you say, okay, if I'm not able to play that yet, let me go and play the eighth, let me play the quarter note groove, which is what I just played a moment ago. 1, and you can play the quarter notes, but try counting the eighth notes as you play the quarter notes. Try 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and some songs are going to require a quarter note groove. Some songs are going to require an eighth note groove. As a musician, as a drummer, you got to be able to play both. Okay, it's perfectly fine if you start off with the quarter note groove, but eventually you got to be able to play that eighth note groove, because once a drummer can do this, then there's hundreds and hundreds of songs you can play. There's different variations of this groove, but this is the core groove for a lot of music. Okay, so I'll back it up a little bit, and we're going to go ahead and demonstrate the eighth note groove. Trying to get it back in the right place here. Let me see where that's at. A little more. Okay. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 for drummers to play a crescendo. And it takes some practice to be able to do this, okay? Is you're gonna play your snare drum, your floor tom, and your bass drum together, all three drums, okay, simultaneously. We don't wanna do this. We don't want, or that's a flam. That's a, we don't want a, no flams there, okay? So one way that, again, if you're a total beginner, never played the drums before, one way to practice that might be to start with your hands. And you start with your stick height low, close to the head, and you slowly raise them, slowly increase your stick height. And it's one and two and three. You stop that crescendo, or you stop that part of the crescendo on beat three. One and two and three. Even with your bass drum, you gotta practice. So you start, if this is your the head of your bass drum head and this is your beater, you gotta start with one and two and three. So you try to gradually increase the distance, okay, or how hard you hit the bass drum head. Okay, so, and the way I've shown students that you can play this, it's one and two and three, and then on the toms. Four and one, okay? Different combinations you can play there. You can play two hits on the snare. Four and one. Just really up to the, you know, the person playing the song. But that fill fits there. So it's a one major fill. It's four beats, okay? Crescendo, one and two and three. Okay. Now what I teach, the way I teach music is I teach my students, number one, how to count everything, but also have them listen for the lyrics of the song. Because you can also use the lyrics as a reference to say, okay, well, when Bruno Mars says, like, I sit by myself, talking to the moon. Okay, so there you can also key in on the lyrics, but it's very important, it's vital that whenever you're playing music, you have to know how to count it. If you know where beat one is, where the downbeat is, you automatically know where two, three, and four line up. Okay, let's keep going with this here. I'll back it up just a little bit. So we've played, start off with verse one, we played the chorus, played verse two, which is really where the drum groove comes in, and you really come in on second verse. We played the chorus again. Now we're going into what is known as the bridge, okay? Typically in music, the bridge is going to sound, it's going to sound different, it's going to be played different than your verses and your chorus. Now, personally, for this song, I like switching to the ride cymbal for the bridge. The rest of the band, they're all playing different chords, right? It's a totally different sound. So I believe that as the drummer, like, well, what can we do to make this different? Well, why don't we change our voice with that we're playing with our quarter notes and eighth notes? Instead of using the hi-hat for the whole song, for the bridge to change it up to get a different sound, a different tonal quality, switch their ride cymbal. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and switch back to eighth notes for now. Okay, back it up just a little bit. We'll go right to the bridge here. And there's a crescendo at the end of the chorus that takes you into the bridge. Okay, play your crescendo, your fill, one and two and three, four and one. And then go right to the ride cymbal at that point. Okay. So that's a basic overview of how to play Talking to the Moon, okay? With the crescendos, you know, again, it's going to take some practice to get all three limbs to play together. Okay. Don't start up here. Sometimes I've had students, you know, when they're first learning how to play crescendos, especially with this song, they start here. Well, you can't start with your sticks way up high or even your, you know, nailing your kick at the beginning, because if you're already at your loudest point, or if you're already loud, okay, or to use a musical term to describe the dynamics or the volume at forte, which forte in music means loud, if you're already at forte, you've got nowhere to go. You're already there. And it's got to go from quiet to louder, okay, from quieter to louder, okay? And then when you go back into the last chorus, okay, that when you play "In Hopes You're on the Other Side," talking to me too, or am I too? Okay, you want to make sure you're hitting your bass drum with your crashes, and you may just need to just to practice this, just practice that right there, because there's nothing else in life that we do that requires us to do that. Okay, so just the physical movement of, okay, I'm moving my, if you're a right-handed drummer, and it could be the left hand too, it could be the left hand, it doesn't necessarily have to be the right hand. It could be the left hand. Actually, I recommend doing that with both, not both hands at the same time. The only time you play it at the same time is if you're playing a roll or a swell, but it can be, you gotta get used to doing that, okay? If you play just the crash only, hopes you're on the other side. It's very empty. The crash, most of the time when you play a crash, you're going to play the kick. Sometimes you can play off beats with the snare. All right. You don't do that in this song. All your crashes in this song, most of them are on beat one, except for the multiple ones that are on quarter notes. One, two. And again, it's four crashes and a quick swell, then you go right back into the groove. And it's counted. It hopes you're on the other side talking to me too. One, two, three, four, three. Okay? So I hope this video is helpful for everyone. This is a great beginner song to start with as far as when you start learning the drum set. I've got a few students that are working on this song, and so and again, if you have any questions, if you're interested in music lessons, it doesn't always just have to be drum lessons. We teach many different instruments at Orlando Fine Arts Academy, and we are currently enrolling new students, especially as we get ready to start a new year, 2021. So thank you for watching. Hope you have a great day. Take care.